Have you ever considered adding a small router to your travel setup? Let's talk about that.
Welcome to David Does. If you're new here, I appreciate you subscribing. If you're not new, welcome back. Today we're stepping into the techier side of travel. Specifically, we're taking a look at GL.inet's latest travel router, the AX1800. Before we dive too deep into this, I wanted to mention that my day job is actually network consulting for a company called Crosstalk Solutions. This channel, however, is generally just for travel gear and some photography stuff. That's one of my main hobbies. But when I saw this, I thought, boy, this fits the bill. Let's check this out and see if it's worth it. You may be asking yourself, what is a router and why would I need one for travel? And to help answer that, first, a router is really just a device that stands you up your own personal network and attaches you to another network, generally the internet. We all have these at our houses, you know, those small modems or modem combo router boxes that connects you to the internet. What it does is it sets you up a personal network and then connects you to the wider web. Now, the question on if this is a good option for you or if you really even need this, that's quite a personal one, but maybe I can help you out with that.
When we're traveling, we should be extra cautious about our cyber hygiene, which really just means making sure that our data is secure. The things that we already do, like using strong passwords and two-factor authentication, is great, but there are other things we want to do. Like if we come across a public charging station and we're going to actually use it, you should have something like a data blocker to ensure that they're not going to try to do something with your device.
It's also a great idea to use some sort of VPN whenever you travel, particularly if you're using some sort of public Wi-Fi like an internet cafe. What this does is it builds a connection between your device and some other secure location that you trust, like private internet access, and encrypts the traffic. This way nobody can intercept it. And that's where this device can help out. This is actually one of the two reasons why I recommend this. You can actually have a VPN already configured, so whenever you roll up to a hotel, you use the easy-to-use app to connect it to the hotel's Wi-Fi, and then your devices connect to this. It builds a secure tunnel back out to your private internet access or whoever you use. It's super easy. You don't have to be a network consultant to figure that out. It's actually quite simple. The other reason I like this is if you're spending a lot of time in your hotel room, which I'll say normally I only do this whenever I'm on a work trip. Whenever I'm on a personal trip, I'm normally out and about trying to see what I can see. But if you're in the hotel room for quite some time and you've ever had a TV set up there that's less than optimal, maybe just one or two channels, you probably thought to yourself, man, I wish I would have brought my Chromecast or my Apple TV and just plugged it in and brought, you know, played Netflix or HBO on it. That doesn't work, especially if the hotel has its Wi-Fi set up properly. You can't cast from your phone to a Chromecast. This would be a way to make that happen and actually works quite well. This has an internet connection that you would connect to the hotel's Wi-Fi and they would see that as one device. Your private network behind this could be multiple devices that can communicate with each other. So you could have the Chromecast connected, your phone, and then stream your Netflix directly to it.
So you may be thinking to yourself, this seems like a lot of work. Is it gonna be worth it? Really, I wanted to show you how easy it is. I have the app pulled up here on my phone. We're outside of a Barnes & Noble. And really, I just went through the basic setup following the instructions of how to set up a local Wi-Fi. Of course, mine is called Full of a Took. All of you Lord of the Ring nerds like myself will enjoy that. But anyhow, all you need to do is click on network, and what we're doing is called a repeater. And we go down here to modify the repeater, and here it's gonna scan. It's gonna look for every network in the area and show us which ones we can connect to. You can see here I have two saved, but those are from my testing. They actually work pretty well. And here we see BN Wi-Fi. This is Barnes & Noble's guest Wi-Fi. Let's go ahead and connect to it. Click join, confirm. And it will take a few minutes here, and it does have a mechanism in place for guest portals. So if you ever joined a network and it brought up a web page saying, hey, accept the terms or sign into your hotel room, this will allow you to do that. It actually associates the router itself to it. Very simple, easy to use. While this waits, we did speak a little bit about VPNs. I'm not going to show you how to configure that yourself. It's very easy to do if you have a subscription to like private internet access. There's a lot of good videos online. It took me about 5 minutes to get set up. However, this has been a really good tool. It's also really low power. I'm using my Anchor power station here to power this. And actually I noticed I had to take my power station out of battery saving mode because it didn't recognize the draw was high enough from this. It thought it was just idling, so it would turn off. So I turned off power save because this thing uses such little power. It's a really nice unit. In general, I've been really happy with this. It's gonna make it in my bag for most of my trips. Of course, like I said, if I'm planning to go on a trip where I'm never gonna be in my hotel room, I'm gonna leave it at home. But if I'm going for a work trip or I'm gonna bring my Chromecast, it's going in my bag. If you have any questions about this thing, let me know. Oh, actually, we're connected now, we're online. I'm always happy to answer those questions. I really appreciate your time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing to David Does.